Hey there, viewers. We all want white, sparkling teeth. But did you know that a bright, white smile can be the beginning of a cavity? We usually don't even realize it. Today, we're talking about how you actually get cavities. Do worms cause them? Could it be medicine? We're talking about all of this and more. Any person, any age, can get cavities. Surprisingly, about 91% of Americans over 20 years old have at least one. There are several misconceptions about how cavities actually form. For instance, there are no worms that dig holes in your teeth to produce cavities. However, there are distant cousins of worms called microorganisms that deconstruct your teeth. Your mouth is never free of microorganisms, even after you've brushed and flossed. There will be millions still sitting on your teeth, tongue, and gums. It's actually kind of creepy. You get these microorganisms in your mouth as soon as you're born. This is something you cannot prevent. It's extremely natural. You can also get them from food that you eat. The number of bacteria when you have your milk teeth is a lot less compared to the bacteria on your permanent teeth. Scientists say that you exchange almost 80 million bacterial cells when you kiss someone for 10 seconds. This would mean a free pass to more bacteria in your mouth. Microorganisms may sometimes bring other guests like bacteria, fungi, and amoebas to join the party. So, how many times do you brush a day? Do you keep mints and breath spray handy? Sound off in the comments section and start a conversation with our bestie community. Research has shown that couples living together for a long time show similar microorganisms in their mouth after testing. If you eat too much sugary food, the number of microbes multiply quickly. Initially, singly appearing microbes start forming large colonies over the surface of your teeth. This is called plaque. It looks like a thin white sheet of film clinging all around your tooth. But don't let that fool you, it smells awful. When sugary foods enter your mouth, they tend to settle in the cracks and crevices of your teeth. Sweet and sticky foods make the entire pH of your mouth very acidic. So what are these little microbes called? Well, they have a really strange name, Streptococcus mutans. Let's call them S mutans for short. This microbe loves acidic environments. They multiply so quickly that huge colonies of microorganisms settle on your teeth in no time. Just like you dig into that sugary chocolate bar, these tiny cellular organisms also thrive on this sugar. They love the sugar you eat. They start chugging down large amounts and produce metabolic wastes in the form of acid. Lactic acid is a major component of them. This is the same acid present in milk. That is why you need to brush your teeth after consuming tea or coffee with milk. You'll often hear pediatricians telling parents of toddlers to clean their oral cavity of their babies immediately after giving them milk. This is just one way you keep your kids' teeth away from lactic acid. Looking for answers on all the latest health and wellness news? Hit that subscribe button and join our millions of followers. Stay up to date on all of our great bestie content. The microbes in your mouth aren't just made up of S mutans. There are hundreds of other microorganisms. Scientists call these microorganisms core microbiome. Believe it or not, some of them can actually maintain your teeth. They can keep you away from yeast infections like rash and bad smell. The good and bad microorganisms start living together on the surface of your teeth. They even exchange genetic material that will help the other survive. In the process, they form a strong bond over the teeth. These bacteria and microorganisms keep eating your sugar and produce lactic acid as a waste product. Your tooth is made up of three layers that are rich in minerals like calcium and phosphorus. The outermost layer is called the enamel, followed by dentine and pulp. The pulp is filled with blood vessels and nerves, which carry the pain to your brain. When the acid starts coming in contact with enamel, it starts taking away all the calcium. This leaves the enamel hollowed and very brittle. The remaining matrix of the teeth just crumbles away. This is the first step towards a massive cavity. After destroying the enamel, acid moves to the next layer, the dentine. Once it's done with that, it reaches the most crucial part of the tooth, the pulp. This entire path created by the acids gets filled with bacteria, just to produce more acid and cause more damage. Before we continue, are you experiencing acidity? Take a quick look at these 9 acidic foods you should stay away from. Once the acid reaches the pulp, it hurts so badly you have to talk to a dentist. The cavities formed in the enamel and dentine are usually painless and can be fixed with some fillings. This is done by removing all the existing microorganisms and bacteria from the tooth, cleaning it, and then blocking that hole with dental cements. Most of the cavities that reach the pulp need root canal treatment, or even complete removal. This is why you need to pay attention if there's a dark spot in your mouth. A cavity in the enamel begins with a bright white spot. This is the enamel losing minerals. You may not catch it when you look at your teeth in the mirror, but your dentist can spot them in no time. This is why visiting your dentist regularly is so important. It isn't just forgetting to brush or floss that causes cavities. It's also acid reflux, dry mouth, genetics, smoking, teeth grinding, and fluoride deficiency. Some of you might even get cavities even if you stay miles away from sugar. There's a list of things that might look like they don't have sugar but are actually really dangerous for your teeth. Let's take a quick look at them. Number 1. Medicine. We generally trust medicine to get our health in check, but they often have hidden sugars. Chewable tablets are filled with sugar. This is just a recipe for disaster. You don't want sugary foods to stick to your teeth. Replace chewable tablets with pills or sugar-free syrup. Cough drops and cough syrups have too much sugar in them. They shouldn't be consumed right before bedtime. Just make sure you brush right away. Number 2. Hard seltzer. Carbonated water, along with carbonated drinks like soda, are equally harmful for your teeth. It not only reduces the pH of your mouth, making it acidic, but also stops the production of saliva. Decreased saliva will not be good for flushing out all the food particles in your teeth. Make sure you drink plain water instead. Number 3. Wine. Does wine turn your teeth purple? Blame tannins. These colored chemicals stick to your tooth enamel and break down the calcium, making your teeth look all gross. Other colored foods like coffee and tea also have these compounds. Wine tastings are usually accompanied by cheese. Cheese is loaded with calcium and can prevent extra tannins from reacting. This protects the teeth from cavities. Number 4. Pumpkin spice latte. This special latte has been trending for quite some time. If you drink too much pumpkin spice, you're just endangering your teeth. It causes a rush of acidity in your mouth and makes it vulnerable to bacteria. Number 5. Kombucha. This fizzy beverage is loaded with antioxidants and probiotics, but drinking too much can eat away at the enamel. Use a straw to drink the beverage without letting it touch your teeth. Remember not to brush immediately after drinking it. This can hurt the enamel even more. Number 6. Turmeric. Turmeric is bright yellow in color and can stain your teeth. Over time, your teeth themselves will turn yellow. Make sure you're not having too much. Number 7. Dry fruits. This is the most nutritious, power-packed snack you can have, but this is true only with non-sugary dry fruits. If you're addicted to dry fruits, make sure you brush your teeth or give them a quick rinse. Otherwise, the sugar will stick. Try replacing this snack with whole fruits like pears and apples. They will give you more fiber, higher water content, and zero artificial sugar. We often ignore our water needs, but why? After all, 60% of our body is just water. Watch and learn more about how much water you should drink in a day. Want to know more about lemon water? Here's another beverage. Drink lemon water every morning on an empty stomach and see what happens. Go ahead, click one. Or better yet, watch both and learn more about how to become healthier. How do you keep your teeth healthy? Let us know in the comments below.